Throne was written during the last month of 1995. I believe the finishing date was 19th of December on it. So it was just the last weeks of 1995. In accordance with the implication of the title, this is a thematic piece evolving from a minute nucleus, two notes. As the work unfolds, a variety of techniques are passed through. Paradiddles, single strokes, ricochet sticking, sweep and cross combinations, four mallet technique. Not forgetting such vital things as attack and tone, which in my opinion are the player's main means to make the drums sing. Hence the title, A Drum Song. Polyrhythms are abundant in the piece, and in the final part there are five different or even more different polyrhythms sounding simultaneously. This piece was written for Evelyn Glennie and it's dedicated to our mutual mentor and teacher in percussion playing, James Blades, in admiration and gratitude. I was, when I wrote this piece, very much thinking of attack and the different qualities of tone one could have with a different attack. So I was thinking very much technically when I wrote it, although it's a thematic piece, as I said. It has been recorded quite a few times, and it is used in competitions and taught in schools also. Some of these recordings are very nice, like the one which you've done for the percussion canon, a very lovely video and good playing. In the last part of it, I am using quite a few polyrhythms, and it starts off with in the left hand, which is playing with two mallets at once, playing the drums and clicking on the rims. Then later the right hand comes in, playing triplets. First normal triplets, and then I have dual accents within the triplets, and then later I have motif of four notes. That's how these polyrhythms evolve towards the end. In my solo works, like Frum and Prim, Keem and other pieces, I am always thinking of the player himself. I feel that the player should be, however exactly the music is notated, the player should be free to make the music his or hers own. That is very important to me, that the player feels that this music comes from him. Not that he's trying to imitate a composer or trying to imagine how the composer wants it. I want the player to think how I want to play it, and how I want it to sound. Normally, the tone and attack and the tuning of the instruments are extremely important. And for me, it reveals a lot about the player's thoughts about the pieces he's playing. So that's very important to me.